our international guidelines actually recommend that patients see a kidney specialist at a certain EGFR, certain EGFR of less than 30, to actually get on the kidney transplant list when your EGFR is 20 or less. And you're actually diagnosed with chronic kidney disease when your EGFR is less than 60. So we have international guidelines that say, hey, let's use this number to diagnose patients and to really, you know, determine when to refer them to specialist care or when to actually have them gain transplant waitlist time for kidney transplant. And that's really important for Black patients in particular because they progress more quickly to needing dialysis or needing transplant more quickly than other racial groups. So if we're assigning them with higher kidney function or better kidney function, then as Nicole already stated, that it's we're referring them too late because of this correction and putting patients at a better kidney function for Black patients.
And I want to be clear here. It's not that we're saying that the medical community establishment is purposely trying to exclude African Americans from getting transplants or that they're not taking their level of disease seriously. We're not indicting the medical community and saying you guys are purposely not giving African Americans transplants. However, what we do have to recognize is that this disparity, this discrepancy is in existence, and we have to figure out why is it still being used.
That's the number one, that's the million dollar question is why did these two studies show what they showed? But we know what can affect kidney levels are medications, diet, high meat protein diets can affect these things. So it's not race. We shouldn't be having a race correction. We should be actually really figuring out why we have these differences. And we really can't use those studies to apply that to the entire Black population. So it's really inaccurate and it's a really flawed practice to be continuing to use and applying this so broadly for patients that are really at high risk of kidney disease and having poor outcomes.
Yes, that's very well put. You know, my next guest, she has also experienced lifelong kidney problems. Take a look.
I have been dealing with renal kidney failure since I was 12 years old. I've had hemodialysis for 12 years straight. And for transplants, I started having kidney issues when I was 12. I was very active, and over a two-week period, the level of activity began to decline. I was sleeping, I wouldn't eat, nausea, vomiting. I could barely walk and was having to be carried into our home. At that point, my mom decided to take me in. The doctors told her that I was in complete renal failure and that I needed to go to the hospital immediately. He could not guarantee that I would not die while sitting in my mother's car. African Americans are at a higher risk for kidney failure. When I first found out that I was pregnant, I also found out that my creatinine levels had started to increase. The levels were high enough and the GFR was low enough where they said that I needed dialysis in order to sustain my pregnancy. My GFR was less than 10, and that puts you at stage 5 of kidney failure.